Welcome to another vlog about psychology. That's with a CY. I'm taping today from our offices in Elkhorn, Nebraska. That's where Cy Wakeman Inc. is headquartered. I get a lot of the things I talk to you about on psychology, a lot of the ideas come to me through the email info@cywakeman.com. That's where you can ask questions about how to apply psychology or the reality-based philosophy in your daily work and personal lives. And I give you a way to ask those where you don't always feel outed, like you have to raise your hand in a group that I'm presenting to. You can send them in, and if they're appropriate and seem sincere, I will do my best to answer them on one of our psychology sessions. So here's a great question. Cy, my culture is just plain toxic. When do I know whether it's time to stay or time to go? Now, that question is a bit more complex than you might think, in a different way than you think. It's not about your culture, it's about you. See, you either need to get right with your culture and stay in joy, or you need to leave in peace. Stay in joy is all about stop judging, start helping, jump in, manage risk, make a difference. Leaving in peace is acknowledging that my preference is not to be working in this type of environment. But what you cannot do as a drama diffuser is stay and hate, stay and complain. See, there's no third option. Either stay and play well, or go in peace. But to stay in hate, to stay in complain, stay in sabotage, stay in opinionate is the most unaccountable thing a person can do. That whole third choice isn't there for those of us that are practicing drama diffusing. Secondly, I would tell you, be very careful that you have accurately labeled your culture. Most often that's just a story. The ego eats anger for lunch. In order for our egos to be able to stay fed, it's important that our minds, our egos, find insult where there isn't any. And so I've talked to a lot of people who tell me, Cy, the culture around here is horrible, or the environment is just difficult to work in. They've really labeled culture. And by the way, I think culture is just a series of reasons, stories, and excuses about why we can't do something that we all agreed on and then named it culture. The culture doesn't even exist except in your own mindset. I once had a time where a woman said to me, Cy, this culture that I'm working in is not a great one. And I said, you know, give me some proof, show me what you mean. She actually had me come over to her computer terminal after we've been working together a couple of days, and she goes, here's an example. And I read the email, and it actually said, and this is all it said, you are invited to an ice cream social at 2 o'clock in the lobby today. And I'm thinking, free ice cream. How awesome is that? Because I don't have that same ego filter. And I said, all I see on that email is free ice cream. That's amazing. She was so into her story. She was, oh my gosh, but you don't know the backstory. I'm like, the backstory? You're reading a lot into this email. She said, but you haven't been here enough. The backstory is that HR always plans these events in the afternoon at 2 o'clock because they know that's when my team won't be available because our phone queue is the highest. She actually believed in a company of 40,000 people that HR got together and looked at the data to see when her team would be least available and scheduled ice cream socials appropriately. Now, one of the things that I just have to do when I see that whole ego going on is do some ego busting. Too many times it becomes ego chafing because people don't want to let go of their story. But I said, look, I've met your HR leadership team. If they could make data-based decisions, like planning the worst time for an ice cream social to make sure it inconvenienced you the most, we would have a lot of other different results around here. It's just not even the skill set they have. She did not want to let go of the story. She said, but here's what else, Cy, is I'm lactose intolerant and they don't give any other alternatives. And that's where you know that your ego's in charge, is even in the face of data, there's data denial. You just don't want to let go of suffering. And remember, suffering is completely optional. There's two ways to go through the day, joy or misery. So she said there's nothing available besides milk-based products. And I basically just gave her a big hug and I said, then my advice to you would be not to eat the ice cream. You will probably start farting. It is not that big of deal. But every day you read something that is at face value, very clearly not an issue, and your ego reads farther into it to see insult where there isn't any. So I want to ask you today to think about all the places you're ticked off, and I want you to start separating out what's real and what is your suffering. Suffering is ego-based, it's completely optional, and if you want to live a drama-diffusing, peaceful, successful life, you've got to get good at separating out your reality from your suffering, and you've got to get really good at seeing when your ego is trying to find insult when there isn't any. So keep those questions coming. Hopefully, you're having a great day today.